The logistic equation is a model for population growth. And despite its fairly simple appearance, it actually works very well as a model for realistic situations, such as the growth of a population of a country over the course of 100 years. And I'll describe in words the logistic equation. It says that the rate of change of the population is proportional to the product of the population and the difference between some number m and the population. Now, this number m can be interpreted as a sort of maximum sustainable level for the population over a long term. And the fact that I have a product here says that the population grows more slowly when it's small, if I have p close to zero, and it also grows more slowly when m minus p is small. So the population is close to its maximum capacity. Now, what I'd like to describe in this video is the way that the logistic equation results from assumptions on birth and death rates in the general population equation that I described in the last video. So if we assume that we have a constant death rate, delta equals delta zero, and a birth rate which is not constant, but rather decreases linearly with the population. So I write beta equals beta zero minus beta one p. Now this is a pretty reasonable assumption. One could imagine that as a population increases, it may be less desirable for the population to reproduce, or a food supply may become more limited, which would cause the birth rate to decrease with the increase of population. Now recall the master population model that I introduced. That was dp dt equals beta minus delta times p, birth rate minus death rate times p. Now this was the model from which all the other population models could be derived, just plugging in different birth rates and death rates. So that's what we'll do here. We'll take the death rate constant equal to delta zero, and the birth rate equal to beta zero minus beta one times p, beta zero and beta one constants. And let's plug those in for beta and delta. And what do we get? We get dp dt is equal to beta zero minus beta one p minus delta zero times p. Now this doesn't look like the logistic equation yet, but let's manipulate it just a tiny bit and you'll see how it becomes the logistic equation. Let's factor a beta 1 out of this term. So I get beta 1 comes out in front, and I get beta 0 over beta 1 minus delta 0 over beta 1, and that becomes beta 0 minus delta 0 divided by beta 1. A little bit of renaming, and we get the logistic equation. Call beta 1 k, and call beta 0 minus delta 0 divided by beta 1 m, and there it is. It becomes dp dt equals k times p times m minus p. Now I'd like to discuss in this context why it's reasonable to think of m as sort of a maximum population or a maximum capacity. And the way to think about this is to interpret m as the population level where the birth rate equals the death rate. You could imagine that if the birth rate equals the death rate, there's not going to be any change in population. And so as p increases, it gets closer and closer to m, the birth rate gets closer and closer to the death rate, and so the population will taper off as it increases to level out at population level m. So we can see this algebraically. Let the death rate, delta 0, equal beta 0 minus beta 1 p. Now solve for p, and we get p equals beta 0 minus delta 0 divided by beta 1. So this value of p is the value which makes the death rate equal to the birth rate. And as you can see, this is the same as m, which is the maximum population capacity for our model. Now I have an interesting question for you, and it's kind of an open-ended question. And the question is this: can you come up with other assumptions on death rate and birth rate, other than the ones that I've made here, which would result, again, in a logistic equation for our model? Now, perhaps the k and the m will be different because you've changed these assumptions, delta 0 and beta 0 minus beta 1 p. But I'd still have a k and an m, and I'd still have a logistic equation model. Now, if you can come up with something like that, the next task would be to try to interpret, like we did down below, interpreted m, try to interpret m in terms of the parameters that you cooked up when you defined delta and beta. So this is an interesting question and very open-ended.